Now I know why people move to Portugal. Thousands of foreigners have moved to Portugal in the last 2 years in search of a lower cost of living and a higher quality of life. But is Portugal still affordable? I'm here in Lisbon to find out. Bom dia, we are here at a Padaria Portuguesa, which is a chain of kind of fast food style restaurants that you can find throughout the city. So let's go in and see how much breakfast is. So this is your typical plate of the day that you can get in the bakery. And I can't pronounce it in Portuguese, but it's definitely a phrase that you'll want to learn. We can put it below with a title. And it brings with it a croissant, like a ham and cheese croissant, or any type of bread that you want, a fresh orange juice, nothing out of the carton, and a coffee. And you can get all of this for $3.75. And in the US, you could get just the coffee for $3.75, or just the croissant, or just the juice. So what I found is that in Lisbon, the cost of food is about a third of the price of in the US. Okay, so in the touristy area, the same breakfast menu is almost twice as much. Something like a breakfast with fruit that I got for €6 in my neighborhood yesterday is €12 here. So if you want to save money, definitely go where the locals eat. By far, one of your biggest expenses here in Portugal is going to be housing. And Lisbon ranks around 50th out of 220 European cities for housing prices. So it's not the most expensive, but it's definitely on the higher end. Now, this is a pretty controversial topic because in my last Lisbon video, no matter what I said about the housing, people either said I was pricing it too low or too high. But the truth of the matter is that your housing prices are going to vary widely depending on the type of housing that you get, how big it is, whether it's furnished or unfurnished, whether it's long-term or short-term, and of course also the location. To save a little bit of money, all you have to do is go to one of the surrounding suburbs or areas to the north or south or inland from Lisbon, or cross the river into Almada district or even into Costa de Caparica. So what are we talking about exactly for rent prices? Well, if you rent a room in a house or a flat, you can get prices as low as €350 up to €650 or €750 per month. But if you want something more private and more to yourself, the prices go up from there. So here in Lisbon, for a one bedroom or a two bedroom, you're gonna start around €1,000 to €1,500. And that's for a long-term rental, like a one-year rental. But if you wanna be here just month to month or short-term, the prices can go up easily to €2,500 per month, or even on some of the vacation rental sites like Airbnb, you can find two and three bedroom properties as high as €4,000 or even €5,000 per month. Now remember that the minimum wage in Portugal here for the locals is around €700 to €750 per month. So that can give you a little bit of a perspective as to how high the housing prices can be here.
And if you're looking for affordable rentals that go from a few weeks up to a year, check out Flat.io, the biggest marketplace for midterm rentals. I've been using Flat.io for the last few months to find properties throughout Portugal, from Lisbon to Madeira Island to Porto. But they have a growing number of properties throughout Europe and around the world. What I like about Flat.io is that there's no security deposits for stays shorter than 6 months. The properties are fully furnished, no hidden fees, and your utilities and high-speed internet are included. To check out properties and availability for your next trip, use my affiliate link in the description below. And thanks to Flat.io for sponsoring this video.
Now, once you have a place to live, you will also have your monthly utilities expenses, but don't worry because they aren't that high. Depending on what time of year it is, you can expect to pay between 10 up to 20 or 30 euro per month for gas, about the same for electricity, maybe around 30 or 40 euro per month, and also 30 for your water, your trash collection, and your recycling. Now, many places do not have air conditioning, and in the summer months, it can be pretty hot here, but in many houses, they will have the mini split AC units that also double as heaters, and these can be pretty expensive, so make sure to turn them off when you're not home. But not everyone uses those. I mean, my landlord told me that in Portugal, people don't heat their houses so much as just put on extra layers of clothing. So it's up to you. When it comes to your internet, cable, and phone, the home internet companies love to bundle those services together. So even if you don't watch TV, it might be included in your bill. So high-speed internet can start at around 18 euro per month here, but it can go up to 30 or even 50 euro per month if you're getting fiber optic internet also bundled together with cable. And your cell phone plan will depend on how much data you use per month. A lot of foreigners get the prepaid SIM cards or the pay as you go, and that can start at around 15 euro per month up to 30 or even 40 euro per month if you're getting a bigger plan with like 30 gigs of data or even unlimited. So altogether, depending on how much data you use and how fast you want your internet at home, could go from 20 euro per month up to about 60. Okay, so let's see how much it costs for a prepaid SIM card here at Vodafone. What is the biggest data? So the unlimited is 30?
Yeah.
But that's only for Portugal. Okay, I guess I'll get that one because that'll mostly be in Portugal, yeah. That's less than half the price of the unlimited SIM card for the Netherlands. So I paid 75 euro for unlimited data throughout Europe for 1 month. So yeah, it's a bit more expensive there. Thank you. Mission accomplished. If you're looking to do some shopping, Baixa do Chiado is a really great place because you have the shopping mall here right behind me, and then also outdoors on the street, you have lots of shops, including international brand names like Zara and Nike. There's also some places to get a massage, there's beauty salons, there's pretty much everything that you would need, but I would imagine that this area is probably more expensive than the rest of the city. So it's the normal prices that you would find under these brand name stores in mostly any country. But services are actually more affordable in Portugal than you might expect in your home country. So getting a manicure here is only 10 to 12 euro, whereas a gel manicure in the United States could easily cost $20 to $30. And going to the hair salon, getting a haircut here as low as 10 or 15 euro as well. Maybe for the more higher end salons, you're looking at 25 or 30 euro, which could cost $60 or $80 in the United States. And if you're looking for entertainment, this is also a great place to get tickets for tours, day experiences, and museums throughout the country. So you can enter some of the museums and cultural sites for as low as 5 euro, but some of the day tours that you'll find here behind me in the shopping mall where you can buy tickets at a kiosk can cost between 15 to 35 or even 75 euro. And I also found similar prices on Airbnb experiences. So you've got a range to choose from there, but here in Portugal, there's plenty of fun things to do that won't cost you anything or at the most, maybe a few euro. You can also do some outdoor shopping at places like the Feria de Ladra, which is an outdoor market that is open on Saturdays and Tuesdays. And here you can find pretty much anything you would need from art to clothing and food. So let's check out some of the prices. Let's see, I think the hardest thing is gonna be deciding on what to buy. Here we have some tacos and some vegan tacos. There's lots of pastries, lots of empanadas on a lot of the menus around here, but you can also buy some fresh fruit and produce. so we'll check some of the prices there too. Here at the market, you can get a basket of fruit with apples, pears, or oranges for about €2.50, and you can get 5 kilos of sweet potatoes for €5. You can also get 3 kilos of mixed fruit for €5, so an entire bag. One of the cheapest types of produce I've found in Portugal compared to the US is lettuce. So you can get this bag of lettuce for €1, but you can also buy a bag of spring mix or spinach at the grocery store for €1 that would easily cost $3, $4, or $5 in the US. I like how the market's kind of like built into the steps and the hills of the area here. And it looks like you can just have a beer or a bite to eat. And we're just surrounded by like antiques, DVDs, art, trinkets, you know, your typical flea market, just cooler because it's in Lisbon. This would be a good time to talk about the prices of beer and wine in Lisbon. Unfortunately, it's very affordable. You can get a beer for around €1, up to 2 or 3 for the bigger sizes of beer. And a glass of wine can run you from €2 to €4. And a bottle of wine at a restaurant can be €12, €15. Quite affordable. Well, if you like markets and you like antique stores, then you can definitely find some gems here. You know, one person's junk is another person's treasure. If there's not a Walmart nearby, you can just come to this market and you can find a lot of miscellaneous things that you might need. You can definitely find some deals here. There's pieces of clothing, like some vintage and secondhand from €5 to €25. So depending on what you're looking for, either go back to Chiado, to the mall, or to the shopping streets. But if you're looking for more vintage stuff, check out the market. Regardless of where you live, food is one of your biggest monthly expenses. But fortunately, here in Lisbon, the food prices are pretty affordable, whether you're eating out or shopping at the supermarket. So I'll show you what some of the most common prices for your everyday basket of items will be here. On this entire shelf, I don't see anything that's priced really more than €1 or €2. So regardless of what type of bread you're getting, whether it's a baguette or a loaf of bread, you can expect to pay around that. A few other items you might need from the grocery store include eggs, which you can get for $1 or so for a dozen eggs. Milk can be from €1 to €3 or €4 per carton, depending on what type of milk you buy. And for meats and seafood, I found seafood for as low as €5 per kilo, whereas in the US, it can easily be $20 or more, depending on what you're buying. A fillet of salmon that you can get in the grocery store in Portugal for €3 per piece could cost $8 or $9 in the US. For buying water or drinks in the supermarket, certain drinks like a Red Bull that would cost $3 or $4 in the US is only €1 here in Lisbon. It's also less than €1 for a large bottle of water or sparkling water that could cost $3 or $4 in the US. Obviously, we also have to check out the price of blueberries, as that was a point of debate in my last Lisbon video, and you can find a pint of blueberries here for around €3 or €4. So if you're going out to eat for lunch or dinner, if you just want a casual meal, you can easily eat for under €10. You can get a burger, sandwich, pizza, and a drink or a snack. You can get a small pastry or other snack from as low as €1.50 up to €5 to €8. But if you want to have a sit-down meal like where we are right now at restaurant San Andres, you can get a full lunch or dinner starting from around €9. So here on the menu, we have a plate. You can get grilled fish, octopus from €12 to €15, and that's gonna come with some potatoes and vegetables or salad. But meat is a lot cheaper. So pork is very popular throughout Portugal. You can get pork at the supermarket for as low as 3 or 4 euro per kilo. And you can get a dish with grilled pork here for 9 euro. You can also get fried chicken for 10 euro. You can get grilled beef for 9 to 11 euro. And you can get like a mixed grill with all types of meat or fish for around 30 euro. And you can also get all types of starters in different price ranges. So fresh cheese or olive starts around 1 euro. A cup of soup with some bread can be as low as 2 to 4 euro. So you have a really wide range of options if you want to eat out, but for the most part, you're looking at less than 10 euro, 10 to 15 euro for lunch, and then maybe 10 to 20 euro for dinner. One of the things that is great about Lisbon is all of the different public transportation options. You have the trolley, the train, the metro, the ferry, and there's also Ubers and Bolts here. Now, taking public transportation can be almost the same as doing ride sharing. You can expect to pay around 2 to 4 euro per one-way trip around Lisbon in an Uber or a Bolt. And it's also around 150 to 3 euro for a one-way ticket on the trolley or on the metro. Now you can also get a monthly pass. So for 30 euro, you can have an unlimited pass to use the public transportation around Lisbon. And for just 10 euro more, for 40 euro, you can also go to the surrounding area. Biking is one of my favorite modes of transportation, although I haven't been using it so much in Lisbon due to the many hills and narrow streets around here. But you can get access to Lisbon's version of City Bike using the app Jira for as low as 25 euro per year. So it is a very cheap way to get around. And if you're gonna be working remotely in Lisbon, you can set up with your laptop at most cafes. There's Wi-Fi or you can use the hotspot on your phone. But if you want somewhere more private, you can also rent a co-working space by the day. And this starts at around 10 or 12 euro per day for a desk, or a membership could be around 100 euro per month. Portugal is also known for having a really good healthcare system. And if you're living here, you might be using the public healthcare system, or you might also want private insurance. So locals could pay around 40 euro per month for private insurance, or 100 euro for a family. But expats have reported paying between 70 to 80 euro per month for their insurance. And that can depend whether you get coverage within the country or internationally. I also always travel with emergency medical insurance, and that runs me around $60 or $70 per month. But you'll want to stay healthy either way. So if you want to join a gym here or do some workout classes, that can cost around 30 to 50 euro per month for a membership with ClassPass and some of the more specialty classes, getting up to around 80 euro per month. So that's still about half of what I paid for my gym membership in Miami. So still a pretty good deal. So the question is Lisbon affordable? Well, I think that depends on what your definition of affordable is and what you're used to where you currently live. You can definitely live here on a budget if you were to rent a private room and shop a lot at supermarkets and maybe not eat out as much. I think you can easily keep your monthly expenses here below 1,000 euro per month. But for many foreigners who are moving here from other countries, there could be a certain lifestyle that you're used to. And depending on what your rent is per month, that will really dictate what your monthly cost of living is. So as you know, we talked about that range from 350 euro per month for a room up to 3,000 euro per month or more, depending on the level of luxury that you want and the location. So focus on what your monthly rent is, and then on top of that, with your food, insurance, entertainment, you can keep that within an additional 500 to 1,000 euro per month. So let's say you spent around 1,250 on your rent with another 200 for your utilities and internet. When you add up your food and entertainment and other expenses for the month, you could have a cost of living around 2,000 euro per month to 2,500 euro per month. But if you're factoring in any big ticket items, additional purchases, or travel around the country or continent, then things can add up a little bit from there. But what do you think? What would your ideal cost of living be here in Lisbon? Let us know in the comments below. So yeah, I'll just sit here while you guys finish the video.